the presentation. As you can see, it is written. I want to tell you what is behavior. If I think that I'm feeling very thirsty and I should drink water, so I have thought it. And literally, I'm going to the water cooler and I have filled the gap of the glass and then I have drunk a glass of water. So this has come into my behavior. Behavior simply means an action taken, an action completed in the language of physics. But suppose two of the students write you, Ranu and Bharat, suppose. If they are talking during my presentation, and I feel that they should not talk, and I thought that I should tell them that they should not talk because I'm talking to them, I'm delivering presentation to them. But I just thought, but I did not tell. But you know, through my eyes, through my facial expression, I conveyed a kind of message, but I did not talk to them in the words. So this was my attitude. So you can say that behavior is more vibrant than the attitude. Behavior means like an action. You say that I want to go outside, I don't want to attend the class. This is very pinching. I don't understand what the teacher is saying, but you are not going. And you make your face bad. And so this is not your behavior. But sometime you walk your way and go out. This becomes your behavior. Are you understanding? So in the presentation, there are some behaviors. In presentation, there are some behaviors. So how many behaviors that you need to take care of? There are many behaviors. Like today I'm showing rightly, deliberately, some of the behaviors I'm showing you. Now, number one is written. Can you read it? Respect the arena. Can you understand what is the arena is? Arena means a place of performance. Presentation is also a kind of performance. Performance means like a showing of your talent. Received by the audience, received, understood, applauded by the audience. Now suppose I am showing a kind of my skill. This is the presentation skill and I am showing to you and you are receiving it, no matter you are applauding or not, but you are receiving it. And this is a particular place, so this becomes my arena. So do you see some kind of program like dancing program where some people come after the preparation and they show some kind of dancing skill, and there is a panel of judges, yes, three judges or four judges are there and they show marks, yes, 10 out of 10, 9 out of 10, you know, they watch their performances very carefully and after examining their performances they give them marks. You know, I ask one question from you, that the performers that they come, do they come without any preparation? They do not come without any preparation. They come with preparation. So that means when you show any important performance, you need what? You need preparation. So do you believe that presentation is a communication that you can call it a performance? And if it is a performance received by the audience, then you need a preparation. Okay? But where this performance is taking place? It's arena. And you have to respect this place. You have to respect this arena. And I always say one sentence, that if you do not respect arena, that means you are not respecting this place, then you will never become a speaker. You will never be respected. So how you will respect this place? That you pay salam? Assalamu alaikum to the place? No. Feel the responsibility on your shoulder. How do you feel the responsibility on shoulder? Another question. How you will feel the responsibility on your shoulder when you are talking to the people? You have to feel that I am the speaker and I am delivering this presentation not for myself, I'm delivering this conversation not from a teacher. I'm delivering this presentation, this conversation, this debate, this topic, this whatever, for my audience. You know, when this class was going on, this presentation was going on, when I delivered this to my other students, to my other shifts, then one, two students from the junior classes, they told very funny story. They said that, you know, one of the girls, you know, she was delivering the presentation, and all of a sudden she left the presentation in the middle, and then she took her seat and she complained to the teacher that, teacher, I'm not delivering my presentation, I'm not completing my presentation, because when I was delivering the presentation, the two girls, they were talking. When I was delivering the presentation, the two girls, why? I was talking for them, and why they were talking? So that means she did not, that little speaker, she did not feel the responsibility on the shoulder. You see, when the audience are behaving odd, this is their error. When the audience are not listening to you, they are not serious, it's the matter of the audience. You know, what is your matter? You have not to be odd. You have not to be non-serious. You have to be serious. You are speaking for them. You know, sometimes what happens that you are speaking, they are not paying attention to you. You are speaking, they are not interested in you. No matter. But you have to give your 100% to them. They will not show you their 100%. But you have to show your 100%. They will give you. One day they will give you. When you will become a speaker. But suppose if you say in your first presentation, in your second presentation, even you have not become the speaker, even you have not become the presenter, and you throw your towel and you announce, the teacher, what's the behavior of the speakers? What's the behavior of the audience? I'm talking to them and they are not listening. I'm not, you know, completing my presentation. So that means you are demanding something. Don't demand PhD. Be honest what you say. Honest means, first of all, that whatever you are saying true, one thing, and your efforts should be honest. Your efforts should be honest. Honesty, sincerity must be oozing, must be flowing out of your performance. I have given you the example of the dance, you know, dance performance. Have you seen them when in the group, you know, 15 people?
Yes, sir.
What kind of coordination? With what coordination they are performing? Have you seen their professionalism? Have you seen their honesty?
Yes, sir.
That with what honesty, with what depth these people are performing. So the same when your speaker is demanded, the same you are demanded. That when, and I ask the same question, that when you deliver the presentation right here, it all says, how much the level of your responsibility, how much is the level of your honesty and sincerity. If you show the 100% responsibility, 100% honesty and sincerity, then you see, you are watching me very, very carefully, with somber eyes, with somber face, with seriousness. Why? Because I'm giving my 100%. If you give 100% to the audience, then their behavior would be the same. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Be soft and attentive. You see, you are a speaker. You are not supposed to say somebody, hey, what are you doing? I'm delivering my presentation and you are not watching me. You are not paying attention. You are talking. You are not supposed to say like that. You are a speaker. You should be soft. You should be alluring. You should be motivating. You should not say, hey, or what, or shouting, or, you know, with such kind of behavior you must not show. Attentive means you have to show some attention. You are watching everyone. In the corner, suppose some people are talking, you have to watch them. Attention. You have to show some attention, then they'll pay attention to you. Don't bring a relevant example. Example is the soul of the presentation. I have given you some example here. The example of that girl I have given you. So when you deliver the presentation, there must be some relevant example. In short, your presentation must be dependent, based on the examples, on short examples. So thank you very much for listening to me. Please.